All right, thank you, David. This is new at 5. Hinds County supervisors have voted to shut down the Hinds County jail. I'm Darren Dito.
I'm Stephanie Maxwell. This bombshell comes after several prisoners escaped the detention center in Raymond. 16 WPT Scott Simmons is live at 5 outside the detention center with what this vote means. Scott.
Well, you could say this gets the ball rolling. The sheriff here admits some of the jail cell doors do not lock, and he's understaffed. Councilman Kenneth Stokes says it's a legal nightmare waiting to happen. But if the county gets sued here because of what happens inside those jail cells, well, the county could go bankrupt. His pitch is to close it all down. The matter first came up in a morning meeting of the Hinds County Board of Supervisors today. They were split on that vote 2-2. But later in the afternoon, the issue was brought back up with the arrival of seldom seen Board of Supervisor member Doug Anderson. In fact, we asked him why, but he could not explain to us why closing the jail, in his opinion, was a good idea. The final vote was 3-2. Sheriff Lewis says that it does sound good in theory, but shutting this facility down and building another one is complicated.
So we have to use some reasonable common sense here that we know that we can't close it down today, but we do know that there is a need in the near future.
Do you think we need to shut this jail down? Is that the best option in your world?
Well, you just heard the vote. You heard what the Board of Supervisors said. Again, they make the ultimate decision, and we're going to abide by it.
We hope that long-term it'll be a new jail, but short-term we'll still make improvements to make sure that this jail is safe for everyone.
Hinds County Supervisors Phil Fisher and Peggy Calhoun voted against the measure. They say it makes no sense to vote to close the detention center when there is no plan on building a new one, much less how you would even pay for it. The price tag being thrown around for a new detention center, somewhere in the neighborhood of $30 million. Live in Raymond, Scott Simmons, 16 WAPT News.
Well, Scott, did they discuss a possible timeline with you?
I mean, no, not at all. I mean, in fact, this is a vote in theory, you might call it. They have no hard brass tacks in this plan. Robert Graham said you could be looking as far as 3 years out.
Very early stages. All right, Scott, thank you so much. Well, the Hinds County Detention Center has a long history of problems with locks, electrical, plumbing, and structure shifts. In 1997, Hinds County and its builder, Dunn Construction, were in mediation over a lawsuit which the county filed against Dunn and its subcontractors for sloppy workmanship. 10 years later, in 2007, a man was paralyzed in a fight at the jail and sued the facility for $15 million.